My name is Vikas Nanwana, and I'm a postdoc in the Department of Material Science and Engineering. And today I'm going to tell you how tiny magnets can cure the cancer. We have developed a technology in our lab that has a potential to cure the cancer without any side effects. Cancer is a deadly disease. If you count the number of deaths per disease in the world, cancer stands out second. If you go by stats, in 2017 in US alone, more than 600,000 deaths are estimated due to cancer. This staggering number tells us that the treatment, current treatments, definitely needs improvisation, and we need new and innovative approaches to treat cancer. Let's look how the cancer grows in our body and what are the current treatments. Cancer starts from a cell and it grows and forms a tumor in an organ. If the tumor is located in a particular part of body, like a blue circle, the doctors recommend surgery to remove that tumor. But if the cancer is not detected early, it starts spreading and spreads through the whole organ. And that's where the doctor recommends radiation, where the whole organ is, radiation applies to a whole organ. And if the cancer is detected very late, it's found in many organs. And that's where the doctor recommends chemotherapy, where the patient has to take a dosage and it goes through all over the body. Each of these techniques are considered invasive. Surgeries are never patient friendly for kids and elderly, and radiation and chemotherapy generates a lot of side effects because they just don't target only cancer cells. They also target normal cells of the body. And that's why the patient has to go through a lot of side effects, and the hair loss is the prominent one, but there are more. So we need therapies that can only target cancer cells and kill them. We need therapies, those are non-invasive, that does not involve any surgery, any radiation, or does not generate any side effects. That's where the field of nanomedicine comes in. Nanomedicine is an emerging field which uses advances of nanotechnology to overcome the drawbacks of conventional medicine. A variety of nanostructures are being synthesized in the scale of 110 to 100 nanometer. Basically, they are so small that thousands of them can pack into one cell. And the way it should work is basically they should enter inside the cancer cell and they should just destroy the cell without affecting normal cells. In my lab, we developed this magnetic nanostructure. Basically, it's like a regular magnet, but if you keep reducing the size of this magnet up to a nanoscale level, it becomes a magnetic nanostructure and it offers distinct unique properties. These particles have a special design. What you can see is in the core there is a small magnet, and then you have a coating that holds anti-cancer drugs. And finally, they have these receptors, kind of antennas. So how do we target the cancers? When you administer this magnetic nanostructure inside the body, they have these receptors that recognizes only cancer cells. So it will just go only where the cancer cells are present. And their size is so small, they can enter inside the cancer cell. And once they are inside the cancer cell, we can visualize them in a magnetic resonance imaging. It's a well standard diagnosis technique called MRI. They light up in MRI. So you can confirm if they are present in cancer cells or not. And finally, if you apply alternating magnetic field, which is basically flipping magnetic field at some frequency, we apply it radio frequency. So we call it RF field. So if you flip this magnetic structure at a very high frequency, it generates heat. Now this heat can be used to kill the cancer cells by itself. It can burn the cell, or it can also release the drugs which is loaded in this nanostructure. So let's see how do we do it. Basically, the idea is if the patient has a tumor or the cancer cell spreads, nanostructures, magnetic nanostructures are injected, and because of those receptors present on the surface, they can go and target the cancer cells. And once they are inside the cancer cells, you can do MRI scan, and because they light up in MRI, you can confirm that they are inside the cancer cells now. And once you confirm that, an application of this alternating magnetic field, or as we call it RF field, will heat up this particle and kill the cancer cells. I would like to share some results what we have got recently in the lab. So this test was done on a mouse. A tumor was grown in a mouse, and we took an MR image before injecting particles. So what you see there is a blue dot, that is the tumor, and surrounding is just the tissues. When we inject this magnetic nanostructures, what you see after this, the color of that blue dot has changed to red color, and that confirms that the magnetic nanostructures had targeted this tumor, because magnetic nanostructures affect the contrast of MRI since they are magnetic. And once you confirm that, you apply this RF field or alternating magnetic field, and what we see is the cancer cells die almost 80%. So basically what I'm telling you is, with the dosage of a magnetic nanostructures and an application of a magnetic field, not only we can detect cancer, but we can also kill the cancer cells. Now, there is a long way to go to humans, but imagine if we can take this technology to the human trials and pass it, then imagine how the cancer treatment would be compared to the current treatment. A patient walks into the clinic, takes the dose of a magnetic nanostructures, and just go through MRI scan once to confirm whether the particles are inside the cells or not. And once they are inside the cells, an apparatus chair-like setup, which has these two magnetic coils surrounding it, the patient can sit down, relax, read a book, and application of this RF field, which generates this electromagnetic field, will heat up the nanoparticles inside the cells. Your body won't feel it, but just the particles inside will be at the work, and it will deliver the drug and can kill only the cancer cells. So what this tells us is, this technology has a potential, using these tiny magnets, to treat cancer without any surgery, without any radiation, and without any side effects. I would like to end with this thought that research should not be just about working on a fancy science. It should be about changing people's lives. And I think I'm giving my small contribution.